up, guys? Welcome back to Rob Squad Reactions with your boy Jay.
And your girl Amber.
And we are back today, not with just any reaction video, guys. Today is
Female Friday.
Female Friday. One of our favorite days here on the channel is the day that we bring light to the amazing female artists and bands all around the world.
All right, so we have an artist that you guys have been suggesting quite a bit today, but before we get into that, what do they need to do?
Hit that subscribe button down below, come join the family, and that post notification bell, because we drop videos
every single day.
Every single day, not once or twice, but
three times.
Three of them every single day. So if you hit that bell, you'll never miss a video, and we promise you guys,
don't want to miss a video.
You do not want to miss one. But hey, every Female Friday, as most of y'all know already, your boy Jay has no idea who we got in store. Let us know.
This has been on the list, I think, from the beginning. And last Friday, I was in the comment section on a Female Friday video, and you guys are like, Janis Ian at
Janis
17.
Who?
Janis
who?
Ian. And the song is at 17. But Janis I've seen it Ian. So many times. So when I saw it in the comments last week, I was like, okay, I'll start it, guys. You've said it so much. So here it is. Today we're going to do Janis
Another
Ian
famous
at
Janis. I've never heard the name Janis until.
Oh, that is another famous Janis.
I've never in my life heard the name Janis until Janis Joplin.
Really?
You've heard the name Janis before?
I don't know. I never thought about that. I didn't think
Janis was a very popular name. I've never heard the name Janis before Janis Joplin.
So now we have Janis Ian.
All right. And what was the song? I'm sorry.
At 17.
At 17. Let's go ahead and check it out. Again, if you are new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. Come join the fam. Let's get it. She looks like she's about 17 in this. Let's go. That acoustic, though.
I learned the truth at 17, that love was meant for beauty queens, and high school girls with clear skin smiles, who married young and then retired. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth, were spent on beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone, who called to say, come dance with me, obscenities. It isn't all it seems. It's 17.
So is she giving us kind of like the view like someone who kind of doesn't fit in, or someone who is, you know, kind of looking at things from the outside?
I think that a lot of people probably can relate to this song.
No, a ton of people.
You know, it's that awkward stage when you're not one of the most popular, you know, you're not the one that gets all the attention.
Right.
And so you're making up these scenarios where there are people calling you on the phone that want to talk to you. And it's a sad realization, how the beauty standard kind of affects how you can have to kind of move
life. Hey, and that's that sad thing about, you know, the world we live in reality today, you know, the beauty standard, and God, you see it so much today. Nowadays, oh my gosh, can take you, it can make you a millionaire. Like literally, just because you're a good-looking person, like, you can have no talent. You can just be a good-looking person and, be seen by the right person.
Right. But that's sad. I mean, I'm speaking for, you know, girls who are coming of age and, you know, trying to come
the whole
into
Instagram.
Their, yes, trying to come into their own, and you see all this, and it's not obtainable.
Right.
And this is kind of just in that sense, high school wise.
Yes.
You know, she sees these other girls who fit that standard, and they're getting this attention, and she doesn't, and that's
I feel bad for high school, especially like high school girls nowadays.
It's really tough. The beauty standard that you have to, it messes with you, and she's describing it, and although it's tough to listen to, it's a song a lot of people can relate to.
No doubt.
It's 17. a brown-eyed girl in hand-me-downs, whose name I never could pronounce. Said, pity please the ones who serve, they only get what they deserve. In the rich relation hometown queen marries into what she needs with a guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Remember, Devonshires of quality and dubious integrity. The small town eyes will gape at you in dull surprise when payment due exceeds accounts received at 17. Valentines that never came, and those whose names were never called when choosing sides for basketball. It was long ago and far away. The world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free to ugly duckling girls.
Song like almost makes me sad.
It's sad. I mean, especially it's talking from a small town perspective, and if you never grew up in a small town, you'd understand the politics kind of that go into it. And she's talking about the small town eyes, and you know, this small town girl who marries her high school sweetheart, and that's such a thing, you know. I mean, politics matter in small towns, and then opinions matter, and eyes look at you. And
does that happen a lot?
Yeah. What?
Like the marrying like the whole high school sweetheart.
In small towns, you see last names just over stay. Yeah,
I know about the last name deal. Yeah. Yeah, the high school sweethearts, yeah, married and all that.
For me, without going into too much detail, it's emotional and I can relate to it just because I did grow up in a town where I was a different race, so a lot of people weren't allowed to date me because of that. So this song I can relate to as far as watching these things, right, and not getting to be a part of that kind of part of the social life. Although, you know, I had lots of friends and things like that. That was a struggle. But this song, she's extremely eloquent and she's very poetic, and I just love it.
Let's go ahead and get back to it. Didn't know that was the end of it.
Oh, it's the second time today. Wow, guys. So that was a really sweet, it was a very deep song, and I enjoyed it.
It was sweet, but sad at the same time, you know, and I feel like that took a lot of courage of her to do that.
Yeah, but she made that for, you know, like you said, that was tough for her to do, but I think she made that so other people didn't feel so awkward and bad about their situation.
I think that's a song that, even today, every high school kid should hear.
I think, yes, because then also maybe the ones that aren't in the situation can learn some compassion, because she worded it and she said, like I said, so eloquently and so poetic. It was so poetic. So I definitely think that's something that, like you said, at 17, you need to listen to show kindness or to not feel so alone.
I'm about to have my students listen to that.
No, you are.
Because, I mean, it didn't have any cussing, anything. Like, it was, I'm having my students listen to that, y'all. I really enjoyed that. Thank you so much for that suggestion. But that's going to be the end of today's Female Friday video. As we always send y'all out of here, we love you. We thank you. We appreciate you. Remember, every day that you wake up, you are blessed. And for your new family members, those of you who hit the subscribe button, we give you an air hug. Welcome. Thank y'all for joining the family. But you guys have a goal every day. Mama, remind them of that goal.
Make somebody smile.
That's to make somebody smile. We love y'all. We'll see y'all later. Okay.